Welcome to tonight's game between the Wichita State Shockers and the Cincinnati Bearcats. And before we go any further, let's check in on our Star Watch, Dick. There's a look, Dick, at the starting lineups.
My oh my, take a look at what we have here. Two solid big men matched up with one another at the five spot. It's always great to watch a couple of talented bigs down low.
All 10 players are set, and now for the tip.
Tips up, and the game is on, baby.
On the dribble, gives it up. He goes up with it. Nope. Evans receives the ball, and now getting set up here in a four-round one.
I tell you, the four-round one, spacing's a key. You better have good spacing, and you better have people on the interior that can score with their back to the basket. If you got a big guy who can post up inside and who has passing ability, he's going to create opportunities for the guys on the perimeter. Got to think right now, got to focus defensively.
In the lane, off the mark. They work the perimeter. And we're going the other way.
Hey, look at them trying to pressure the inbounder, Brad.
On the outside. Blocked. Now they work it around the perimeter. For the bucket. That was nice.
Get out of the way, baby. That was absolutely sensational.
Nice to have you along with us tonight. Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews alongside. I'm Brad Nessler. We got a good one going. Missed it. Willis picks up the foul. Well, he commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
Well, it's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy basket.
Well, Dick, here's a player in just his freshman year.
I tell you, what an exciting time in a young man's life. It's that student-athlete experience really preparing him for the rest of his life.
Terrible free throw. He takes the board. They work it around the perimeter. Nice rejection. Number 11. Modest play is having a negative effect on his composure emotionally. He couldn't be much lower, I don't think.
I hate to see a young man struggle like this. Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
From way outside, knocked it down. The power forward handles the feed. Inside, from the corner, in and out. Tries for two. Got it. Gave it up. Goes up for two. Not there. He shoots from the deep corner. He sees goaltending violation. This guy can really score in a variety of ways down in the low block, Dick.
I tell you, Brad, he's a complete player. It's great to watch someone with such versatility out there. It looks as though they have a shooter spotting up.
Takes the jumper. Nails the J. A nice job of getting to the hole right there, Dick.
Well, he spotted an opening, and he just absolutely great first step, and he exploded to the goal.
Count that as a personal foul. Well, I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nestler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
He is going to the line. Gets it.
Makes those free throws count. He wants to go back on that campus as BMOC. Big man on campus, baby.
Oh, this man's in trouble.
Look at that spacing.
With the jumper. It'd be nice if he could get some assistance out there. That young man is doing it all for his team right now.
If he keeps this up, he may collapse. His teammates must pick it up.
To beat the clock. Nails the jumper. Well, let's take a look at the tempo each team is going to try to set for this game, Richard.
Well, whenever you have two teams looking to control the speed of the game, you need to keep your eye on how each team makes changes. Setting the tempo can be an advantage, but adapting can be just as important. Gotta take some pride on a defensive end.
Seconds on the shot clock. He puts it up quick to beat the clock. They get it to go. They move it into the front court.
And the fans love it. Jump with joy, man. Hey, that's my guys yelling.
For two, goes in. Looking for a good shot. Puts up the jumper. The missed shot. Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter. On the dribble, gives it up for the bucket. Drains it. Momentary look from three-point land. He tries the three. Scores it. The Bearcats want to up the pressure here, Dick, and I think they're going to change the tempo of the game with their defense.
You know, it's a great decision, Brad, if you have the right personnel to play full-court defense.
For two, tickles a twine. Washington getting after it and saves it. Number 15 takes it away. Gliding in for the jam.
Sliding and gliding. Nobody rotated over. The defense moves so slowly.
Number 34 with the foul. First personal foul. Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket. Hey, a player's senior year is such an emotional one. The key is to stay focused and not get caught up on being in your last year of collegiate basketball. If you focus on the right things, win or lose, it'll be a memorable experience.
Gets the second shot. The man might be in a little bit of trouble here, Dick. Cross court. Shoots. Perfectly executed. How about that play? They went through the high post again.
They got into one of the most valuable parts of the court, Mr. Nessler.
With a great block. Pushes it up. He puts up the J. Nope. Trying to feed inside. Loose ball, saves it. Great play. Morris manages to keep it in. Around 8 minutes remaining. Down inside. Goes up for two. Scorches the net. Looking for the pick.
Hey, it's important that the dribbler really turns that corner hard when he's using that ball screen.
And come up short. On the outside. He tries the jumper. Gets the J to fall. Let's see if they can get a good shot this trip. Tries to get around the trap, but he can't do it.
Well done. Great trap.
And a timeout's called. We got a break in the action. Stay tuned for more NCAA basketball coverage. Just about ready for play to resume. They've got a three-point shooter spotting up. Bust the J. About 7 minutes remaining in the game clock. Way out on top, controlling the ball, dumps it in. The block. Entry pass in the paint with the J. Scorches the net with a J. Gets the rejection. shot. About 6 minutes remaining in the game clock. Jumper. Jumper won't go. Both teams looking to get things going here. They'll work it around the arc. Puts up the J.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Moving it around the perimeter. He shoots the jumper. Can't connect. Looking to move it around the perimeter. Takes his jumper. Knocks it down. Handles the feed. Nails the J. Five minutes left in the game clock for the bucket. Can't put it down. Gave it up. The freshman has a brain cramp there and commits a turnover. This is what you're supposed to do down low, is go up strong.
I tell you, it was great post play. Clinic 101 on how to explode to the goal.
Down in the low block, trying to work the lane. The missed shot. Cross court. Goes up with a shot. Nope. Working it around the perimeter. About 4 minutes remaining on the game clock. Way out on the right wing. Tries for two. And scoring.
Pressure that basketball. Help one another. Communicate.
Looking for a good shot. Goes up for two. He can't get the hoop to fall. Oh, yes. Washington handles the pass and come up short. Number 32 with the ball. Looking for a screen on top and got it. Goes up. Bust the J. About 3 minutes remaining on the game clock. On the dribble, gives it up. He pulls up with a jumper. Nails a sweet jumper. For two. Off the glass and no good. Buried it.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. No good. With a bucket. He nails the bucket. We're at the 2 minute mark. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Great block shot. He has taken his team completely out of this game.
These young guys have to remember to let the game come to you. Don't force the action.
Take a look at the sophomore.
Hey, underclassmen are an important part of any program. With a year under his belt, the coaching staff expects solid play from him.
The Bearcats want to up the pressure here, Dick, and I think they're going to change the tempo of the game with their defense.
You know, it's a great decision, Brad, if you have the right personnel to play full court defense.
And let's take a look at a player who's really having a good game here tonight.
I tell you, Brad, he's been awesome, baby. He's a PTP'er. I tell you, what a great performance.
Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc looking for the open jumper. From the corner. Missed it. We're at the 1 minute mark.
Dump it inside.
There's a double team waiting there. They work it around the perimeter. Tries for two.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Way out on top, controlling the ball. He fouled him. Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits a foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket.
To the line. Foul shot, no good. The second shot. Shot clock is dead. The Bearcats are cranking things up at the defensive end, and they're going to extend that pressure.
An aggressive move on their part, Brad. They'll be looking to force some turnovers.
Off the glass and no good. Number 32 takes the pass. Fadeaway jumper. Look at that follow through.
You talk about versatility. There aren't many guys that will make that fadeaway jump shot. Late touch, impossible to block that shot.
At the end of the first half, the Bearcats trail by one. Cincinnati is practically handing the ball over to the opposing team like it's a Christmas present or something right now, Dick.
Hey, any team would gladly receive this kind of nice gesture. I bet they're not getting anything but a mouthful of criticism from their coaching staff.
Looks like they're going to go with a full court man-to-man press, Dick. They work the perimeter. He unloads. Doesn't go. On the outside. Puts up the jumper. He's taking too many unnecessary shots, Dick.
And he's costing his team their rhythm.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Buries it home.
At least you make the highlights letting him do that.
Well, this man's in trouble. Inside. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper.
If they can get off some good shots and easy buckets, it might turn around this awful stretch of shooting for them, Brad.
Easier said than done, though, right now, Dick. They're working around the perimeter. He attempts the jump shot. Can't connect. The Shockers are on the run. Goes up for two. Off the glass and no good.
trying to go inside.
Definitely a foul. Well, it commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
Well, it's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy basket.
With the pair. He gets it to go.
Drained it. That's on the nylon. NBN.
Dick, you got to be prepared when you go up against this team. They love to pressure in the full court.
Hey, you've got that right, Mr. Nestler. They like to get in your face and force you to commit turnovers.
He shoots from the corner.
Excellent jump shot right there.
Side from the corner, scores it.
Hey, he should know by now you don't leave your guy open.
Not a very smart move. Too much. That's a foul. He gets the tough layup and a foul to go with it, Dick.
Hey, that was awesome, baby, with a capital A.
How important is it to get to the free throw line?
Well, you know, those bonus points, Brad, you get those simple points. They add up at the end. Plus, you get people into foul trouble.
They've got them right where they want them, Richard.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing. Oh, he's got hops like you, man. He got hops like you.
Yeah, it is pretty similar.
Wow. I didn't realize my partner was a high-riser.
Tries to get around the trap, but he can't do it.
Great job of containing the man there, Brian.
It's a team effort across the board so far today, Dick.
I tell you, it's been great to watch these kids really working with one another out there. They all have individual skills to put the ball in the hoop, but that isn't always what's best for a team. Everyone needs to get touches so they can feel involved. Look at that spacing.
Unloads off the mark for two. You betcha. Number 34 is called for the foul. Well, I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nestler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
I'm not sure this is the guy you want to send to the free throw line.
I'll tell you one thing, Brad. He values these looks. A good opportunity to put points on the board.
If you can't miss free throws, Dick, it's going to kill you somewhere down the line.
Well, you got to convert. That's the one thing, like football special situations. You got to be able to execute there.
Trying to pack it inside. With the J, the missed shot, gave it up. He goes up with it, gets the J to fall. Looking for a good shot. Launches away. And off the mark. It looks as though the students are all wound up and ready to agitate the opposition.
The student section looks like they're having a great time.
They look to get it to the inside. He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot. The Bearcats prefer a more balanced attack. They play up-tempo at times and then really settling in the half court at other times.
Brad, they like the balanced attack. They don't feel like they can always play up-tempo or always play in the half court. Therefore, they mix it up and do a little bit of both. I think this style works for them.
Dick, you got to be prepared when you go up against this team. They love to pressure in the full court.
Hey, you've got that right, Mr. Nestler. They like to get in your face and force you to commit turnovers.
Trying to feed the low block. Let's watch the move as he works his man and on a fadeaway jumper. And a momentary look from three-point land. He puts up the J. Nails the J. For the bucket. Goes. On the outside. He does the sweet fake shot. He tries the jumper. Off the mark. The small forward gets the ball. And it's blocked. They'll work it around the arc. He shoots from the top of the key. Knocks it down. Tries for two. That's good. Moving it around the perimeter. Go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper. Makes it.
Great pressure, great double team. Really explosive.
Cross court. Look at these fans. They're loving it.
My goodness, it's chaotic in here.
And we got a whistle and a foul. Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket.
You'll get the free ones. First one, good.
He converts on that free throw line, and that's major.
He may be in some trouble here. Tries to get around the trap, but he can't do it.
Are you kidding me? He tried to beat it, but he couldn't, Brad.
He can't beat the trap.
Great job of containing the man there, Brad.
On the elbow, they feed down to the low block. Here's the offensive drop step in the low block, but better defense.
I tell you, the defense doesn't allow him to get to the baseline.
Get an open three. I wonder if he's ever going to get any help from his teammates, Dick. He's doing it all and then some.
I'm sorry, Brad, but this young fella seems to be their only hope at the moment.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. Who wants it? And he saves it. And the ball's dribbled out of bounds. Gives it up. He shoots from outside. He knocked down the three-pointer and picked up the foul.
You know my favorite word in sports is, Brad?
Water break?
No, concentration, baby. That was great concentration on the free ball.
I think it's important to get to the free throw line, Brad. It demonstrates that you're playing aggressively and that you're not settling for the jumper.
Dick, you got to be prepared when you go up against this team. They love to pressure in the full court.
Hey, you've got that right, Mr. Nestler. They like to get in your face and force you to commit turnovers.
On the left side. from the corner. 10 on the shot clock. He makes the block. Great hustle. There's the rejection. He dribbles the ball out of bounds. Now let's check back in now on our Star Watch player. Gave it up. With the jumper. College basketball is special to me for that reason right there, Dick.
The Ruckus fans are going nuts. They're going bananas, Brad.
8 minutes left in the game clock. Go into the low block. Jumper can't connect. He hammers it home. For two, it sticks. And they come with a double team to stop it. Shot blocked from behind.
He set him up nicely.
Off the glass and no good. He buries the shot. About 7 minutes remaining. And the slam. Here's a double team. And we've got a change in possession here. How about this one, Dick?
Hey, look at him hammer this one down. Send a message, young man. Send a message.
They're going to have to find him. He cashed in on the layup and gets the foul.
He knew he was going to get fouled, Brad, but he took the hit like a man.
He goes to the free throw line. Makes it. They have found their stroke at the stripe tonight, Dick.
This has always been an excellent free throw shooting bunch.
The Bearcats will probably be better off if they resort to playing in the half court for the rest of the game, Dick. Given the time and score, playing up-tempo really isn't the smartest thing to do.
Hey, with the lead, they have to really focus on defense and defensive stops. The goal now should be to run sets and keep the clock from stopping.
Washington handles the pass. Working it around the perimeter. Launches the three. And score it. About 6 minutes remaining in the game clock. On the wing. Puts up the J. Scores it. Looking for a good shot. The student body is rocking tonight.
Aren't they great, Brad? I love it.
Well, whose team tempo went out? That's a question right here, Dick.
You know, Brad, tempo is always important. Every team has their philosophy, and it's up to the players to follow the game plan.
What should they do here, Dick?
I'd call a timeout and see what's going on out there. There's definitely some miscommunication happening.
The Bearcats seem like they want to play this game at the next level on defense, Nick.
Hey, look out for the full court pressure, Brad. It'll be interesting to see how the pressure will be handled.
About 5 minutes remaining.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented.
Here's a block from behind.
My man was on a mission.
Gets it to fall. Controlling the ball. Way out on the right wing. He misses the J. The point guard receives the pass. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Tries for two. He misses it. We're at the 4 minute mark. Goes up with it. He knocks down the jumper.
Great job getting back defensively.
He gets the rejection. The power forward takes the pass. He misses the jumper. Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits a foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket.
The Bearcats are a pretty good free throw shooting team, Dick.
Well, you know, when a team shoots a high percentage from the foul line, it means that they realize the importance of free throws.
He misses the second shot. Willis receives the pass. Takes his jumper. He misses the J. On the dribble, gives it up. 3 minutes left on the game clock. Gave it up. Goes up for two. Rims out. Now trying to feed the low block. Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper. He misses the jumper. Fed the low block. Goes up. Knocked it down. For two. Rims out. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. The fadeaway jumper. Look at that follow through. Sinks the shot. Now they'll bring it up.
Inside.
Takes the jumper. He drains the jumper. That was a great delivery on the back cut, Nick.
Great recognition by both players. The backdoor cut is one of those types of plays you love to see.
He shoots the jumper. Busts the jumper.
Double team now. Bad angle.
Great trap. They managed to keep the defender in check.
Well done. Great trap.
9 points is the difference now.
A difference that can change in a heartbeat if you ain't careful, Brad.
Well, it's time to start fouling. They got to stop the clock, Dick. Let's take a second look at this three. Foul, and that stops the clock again. And the clock stopped with a foul. He's typically really good from the charity stripe, Dick.
I'll tell you one thing, Brad. He values these looks. A good opportunity to put points on the board.
Makes the shot. Time out on the floor, folks. More ESPN coverage coming up right after this. We'll see who's got more coming out of this timeout as play resumes. On the right side.
Tempo to game, really important here. You want to establish a good tempo.
Moore handles the feed. This young guy's not the greatest from the charity stripe. Let's see how he makes out.
He just needs to focus on the rim.
Takes the medium range jumper. Missed the jumper. Now they're into it. That's got some people out of their seats.
What a reaction, Brad. The fans are loving it.
A chance for one and the bonus. No doubt about it. Shot good. Dick, you got to be prepared when you go up against this team. They love to pressure the full court.
Hey, you've got that right, Mr. Nestler. They like to get in your face and force you to commit turnovers.
Jumper won't go. Moore handles the pass. They're working around the perimeter. Cincinnati wins this game in convincing fashion.
The outcome was never in doubt. It was always a question of how dominant they would be.
It's been a fun game, and as always, my partners alongside have enjoyed you being with us. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler. Good night, everybody.